Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll see how to add the data disk for the Azure virtual machine. So I have logged into the Azure portal and navigating to the virtual machines. So I'm having VM 01 running in my subscription. And now we'll see how we can add the data disk in this VM. So under the settings, you can click on disk, and here we can see OS disk and data disk. So now let's add our data disk here. So either you can create and attach a new disk, or you can attach any existing disk. Now we are going to create a new disk. In case if you have redeployed any VMs and you have a data disk in the previous VM, and that you can attach here. Now I'm going to create and attach a new disk. So here you can provide the data disk name. Data disk underscore one, and the storage type, whether you want to go with the premium or standard. So I'm going to select standard HDD, and the size of the disk. So based on the selection, the storage type, the IOPS will get differed, and then you can click on apply. Okay, so let's wait for this to be completed. Okay, updated virtual machine. So now let's log into this VM using RDP. Okay, now if I go to this PC, I don't see the data disk here. So what you have to do, go to the disk management. Okay, so open the server manager and click on tools, and here you can go to the computer management. And under storage, click on disk management. So here we are getting the pop-up for initializing the disk that we have newly added. So we can click on OK. And now we can see disk 0, disk 1, and disk 2. So disk 1 for the OS disk, and disk 0 for OS disk, and disk 1 for temporary storage, and disk 2 for the data disk. So you can just right click and create the new simple volume, and you can assign the letter and just format with the NTFS and click on finish. Okay, now I can see the data disk here. So now you can store the application related data into the data disk, because the temporary storage, this is a temporary in case if we stopped, and once it is deallocated, then the data which is stored on this temporary storage will be gone. So we should not save any application related data in this D drive. And for OS, this is related, the C partition, it's dedicated for the OS. Okay, so let's say I wanted to extend the data disk 1. So just click on it, and under size plus performance, here you can select the desired size that you want to extend. For example, currently I have 32 gig, which is the minimum size, and I want to go with a 64 gig. So select a 64 gig and click on Save. Now it's updating the disk, and once this is completed, then we'll go back to the VM01, and from there we can extend it. Okay, let's wait for this to be completed. Okay, so now we can see successfully updated disk. So let me go back to the VM, and I can see it unallocated 32 gig for disk 2. In case if you're not seeing it, you can just right-click the disk management and select a rescan disk, which will populate the newly added disk. And now you can select the data disk and click on extend volume and click on next. So we are not going to use the disk 3, only the disk 2 available size, and click on finish. Okay, now we can see it has a 64 gig for the disk 2. Okay, so we have extended the data disk without any downtime. But if we wanted to extend the OS disk, then we have to shut down the VM, and then only we can extend it. For example, if I go to the data disk, I mean the OS disk, let me just select the OS disk, and size plus performance. And if I select 256 gig, I don't see the option to save it because the virtual machine is currently running. So it has to be, the disk has to be unattached or the managing virtual machines are deallocated. So then only we can increase the OS disk. Okay, now I'm going to stop the virtual machine so that I can increase the OS disk. So let me open the VM01 and click on stop so that it will be deallocated status, and then I can go ahead and extend the OS disk. Okay, as you can see, it is stopped, deallocated, and now go to disk under settings and click on the OS disk. As you can see, currently we have 127 gig, so click on that and click on size plus performance under settings, and you can select the size that you want to extend. Let's say if I select 64 gig, it says reducing disk size is not supported in Azure to prevent data loss. So the next available size will be 256, and click on Save. So now we are updating the OS disk, and this is completed. And here, if you want to extend further the data disk as well, we can do that from here. Okay, you can select the next size and click on Save. So this will extend the data disk. So I'm just extended the OS and data disk again, and now let me go ahead and start the VM. Okay, so now I have logged in back to the VM and opened the disk management. You can open the disk management from the server manager, or you can also run the diskmgmt.msc command. And from here, we can see the disk 0 for the OS disk. We can see the unallocated space. So you can just right-click here and extend the volume. Click on next, click on finish. So now it becomes 256 from 127. And we have also additionally added the disk 2 for the data disk. And again, you can right click here and extend the volume and click on next, finish. So now this is 127.98. Okay, if I open the File Explorer, and here I can see the new size got affected for the OS disk and for the data disk. Okay, so in this video we have seen how to extend the OS disk and data disk. That's it in this video, and I'll see you in the next. Thank you.